Roy Williams has left the building. I wish Shut Up would follow. But, that has not happened yet. John, you want to make any statements on the election last night?
No.
It's over. It's
well, over. That's one way to get around it. I mean, it didn't shock me.
Well, nothing shocks, you know, or anything like that. But, you know, that's why we have elections, and there's an electoral college, and that's what happens. So.
That's the process.
John, you talked about immaturity.
Yeah.
Boy, did you hit
I wouldn't get upset if I was more mature.
So what?
I wouldn't get upset if I was more mature.
The more mature we are, the least this and that we are.
But my question is, how do you look mature? I mean, you know I'm a sexy all-American guy on TV every morning, a living legend, icon. But how do you look?
Boy.
But some people may not think I'm mature, so how do I look the part?
Well, you look mature. How's that?
Well, that's coming from a minister, though.
That's right. You look mature. We're mature adults, is where we are, as how we look. But no, I was mentioning the guy that I knew when I was young, and he just looked 30 years old, but he was 18, and I thought he was a coach or something, but he was my age. He just looked mature, that's all.
Some the lucky ones did. With the baby face.
You got me. You made several good points there, John.
Yes,
you
sir.
Seldom change until you have to.
Absolutely.
Now, how true is that?
Well, it's real true. It's real true. It's kind of like Roy was just saying in here, you know, and whether, you know, the you want to use the heart thing or whatever he's talking about, but it's just like my father. My father, bless his heart, and I love him to death, but, you know, he smoked 3 packs a day for years. There was years we didn't have a picture of him without a cigarette in his hand. He just always smoked. But one day they came and said, hey, Mr. Dees, we're going to take your voice box out. And we're going to go in there and take one last look at it. And if you can possibly quit smoking, it sure would do you some good. And after 40-something years of smoking on his 60th birthday, he said, goodbye, old friend, and cast it away. And that saved him. It gave him another 10 years. He still died.
Wow.
He still died of related things, but Daddy was never going to change until they said,
you have to.
You know what? Your voice is going to come out if we don't. And that kind of got his attention. So we seldom change until the pain of not changing becomes great enough.
What about if I freak out under pressure?
Well,
which you usually do.
And
you don't handle pressure well at all. Let's just say it.
Let me say this, Steve.
I don't like pressure.
Yeah, I know.
I don't like it either. I don't like it either. But the more mature we are, the more we handle it when we are under pressure. And part of being mature is saying, hey, I've been through something like this before. I know that we'll get through it again. And it's like the veterans on a football team. Forget, you know, but let me refer to that. The more veterans you have on a football team, when like the other night against Alabama and LSU, great football game. But
going to bed.
Well, you know, for the last 2 minutes, you
loyalty.
Were gone. Exactly. But a lot of times when you have some veterans who've been there under pressure, same thing with life. Same thing with life. A lot of times more mature adults, when something big happens, it's something to fret about, be upset about. But maturity says you handle it calmly and trust God, and you work through it.
You got kind of personal, John.
Got kind of personal. Okay.
A mature person strives to control his mouth.
Yes.
Where's the duct tape?
When does that start?
Well, don't
insult people. Shut up, Tom.
Where's the duct tape?
don't insult people, Jamie. And of course, you never do.
But you made fun of my granddaughter.
Of granddaughter? Oh, yeah. My goodness. Oh, yeah. That's
because
right.
You said babies are selfish.
Babies are selfish. That's right. Yeah, I've already gotten in trouble with a few grandmothers on that one, including the one I'm married to.
Right. Exactly. Nancy got on to you.
No, she said, don't use Emory Hannah as an example.
But they are when they
come into the world screaming, I want to be changed, I want to be fed, I want you to, you know, take care of me.
And
it is me, which that's what I'm saying. And and in the baby, it's precious, it's sweet, it's a baby. But when you're 45 years old, some people are still a baby and want to be treated like
a baby.
Why
do we talk to them like that?
Isn't that weird? I mean, really, you would talk completely normal about the baby.
I know, like they know what we're saying.
Why is that?
I don't know.
Like
now, here's something
dog.
I don't like.
What's that?
But I do. A definition of a gossip is hearing something we like about someone we don't like. Now, I'm all in on that.
Yeah, well,
remember what I told you about Shut Up?
Yeah, sure. Well, me too. I mean, we all love to gossip.
I know. I heard you told me first.
Yeah, that's right. It came from me. There you go. Now, we all like to gossip, but God wants us to control our tongue. And we
it just keeps getting worse. Oh. Don't speak what's on your mind.
Well, there you go.
No.
I didn't say don't speak what's on your mind. Some people just say, well, I'm just frank. And not you, Frank. But how'd that go, Frank? That's it. But I don't mean like that. But sometimes I'm just Frank. You know, we got to care. We got to be careful how we speak to people.
Like muzzle our mouth. You said, how do we muzzle our mouth?
There you
just
go.
Don't be so harsh. There's a nicer way to say things.
Not what you say. It's
okay,
how you
John.
Say it.
You just hush. There's no way to talk good to you.
What I got, John?
What
I got an eye problem. Not an eye problem.
Eye problem. And we all do, and we're going to talk more about that this coming week in just the
I don't know if I can stand it.
What now?
I don't know if I can stand it.
Well, that's why the book of James is such a great book. Because
we're going to strap you in that chair on the front row so it sinks in.
Our selfishness is when we want only what we want when we want it. We're going to have conflict with others.
Isn't that the truth?
But it ought to be all about me, John.
It should be. It should be. And I've studied that a lot, that it should be all about you, Jamie. You deserve it, and we all should do that. But
I'm glad I have boots on today.
Johnny Lee, let's change the subject.
Yes,
play football at Auburn under the great legendary Shug Jordan.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Auburn right now ain't going to win another game.
No, it doesn't look like that.
I mean,
Alabama A&M. Yeah.
Okay, I forgot about that.
Yeah, we'll beat Alabama.
Somebody told me
A&M.
I'm
predicting Alabama to beat Auburn.
Somebody told me that they tried to move the game to Alabama, but they're going to finish with three wins.
Yeah.
Jay Jacobs, there's a thing going on now to save Jay Jacobs' job. Mm-hmm. That's in the papers. Sometimes this morning. I read it yesterday because I know how to work my iPad. So I'm a step ahead. They're trying to save Jay Jacobs' job. They say Chizik's gone.
Well, you know what? All I know is I know Jay Jacobs. He's a great guy and a wonderful fella. But I also know that, and I was just talking to one of the biggest contributors to Auburn University yesterday morning. He's a good friend.
And
all I know is there's a big drumbeat out there for change. And so, you know, and that's at any program. Once the major donors get to where,
enough.
Yeah, and it's costing the town.
Well, they clean the clean house. Do they all have to? If Jacob stays, does the whole football staff go?
Well, it's just conjecture on my part, but, you know.
You love Auburn as more than anybody.
Yeah, I do. And I would say that the powers that be that write the checks, I don't think they're going to have a partial anything.
I mean, I know you can't
think anything
true.
I think it costs them more to keep them there in the long run.
Yeah, well, you know.
Because what names have you heard possible candidates to replace it?
Same as you, Charlie Strong, Petrino, Jimbo Fisher from Florida.
Would Jimbo Fisher leave?
I wouldn't think so. Other than I've heard he really has, his wife's from Auburn, he really has, I've heard this. Now, I wouldn't. I would stay at ACC. It's easier to win a championship out of the ACC than it is out of the SEC, especially with Saban across the state from you.
What do you think about the Alabama-LSU game?
Awesome football game. It was an absolutely awesome football game and the mark of a true champion. It really, really was. You know, if LSU can make that first down instead of running the wildcat that they ran, where everybody on Alabama's defense says that guy's going to get the ball, take that play over, it could have been a different. But if
you had a church member.
Yeah.
If you had a church member that loved Alabama football, studying all the grew up.
I got hundreds of them that love Alabama.
But went to bed with 2 minutes to go before the game was over. How would you describe that?
I would call him a sleepyhead. that's what I would call him.
Lack of loyalty for his team.
I think.
Well, there's nothing like getting woken up and saying, well, you know, there could be other things, but you said
they won.
Alabama won.
Yeah, they won. That's right. And there's
and having that cheerleading outfit on help.
Yeah, I hear you.
Well, that's not
so. What are you predicting now for the national championship game? Where do you see everybody going?
I see Alabama going, and I think Oregon.
Can we beat Johnny Football?
Yes, because LSU did.
I mean, Auburn beat LSU 12 to 10.
Well, lost to LSU.
I mean, lost. Not to, and won.
And I am sitting, I promise, I'm sitting there watching Alabama and LSU, and I'm thinking, how did we stay on the field with LSU and almost come within, you know, a muff punt? We could have gotten.
Because every quarterback we play plays like Tom Brady.
Well, that guy, you know, Mecklenburg.
Mecklenburg.
It was a fabulous night, and Gary Danielson was describing him as. He was hot.
He was hot.
But LSU.
They were clicking.
I like what Vern Lisker said. I've watched that Valentine. Alabama ain't done nothing.
Don't be too optimistic.
I think Johnny Football is amazing, but against LSU, first two series, take them down, score. You think they're going to blow LSU. LSU adjusted and shut him down. I think Alabama will do the same.
Johnny Lee down at Cross Point Church, smack dab across from Bob Jones High School. Go by there and don't forget, order your turkeys and your hams right now from Zeke at Pizza Inn for Thanksgiving on Highway 53. We got to get out of here
for the day. Thank you, Johnny Lee.
Hey, see you Sunday morning.
Thank you, buddy.
And 7 o'clock p.m. and a.m. here on ZTV.
Have a great day.
See y'all.